management system of phytosanitary risks. KEFIS launched this program of facilitating imports, the ASIP, in January 2013, through support from the Netherlands government. And for 2 years, the KEFIS team officers and the Dutch experts have been working together closely in the development of the system that we are going to launch today, the plant import and quarantine regulatory system. It is expected that the system will have a positive impact on protection of plant resources, improved food security, enhanced surveillance of risky plant materials, environmental protection, and safe exchange of plant materials, and also enhanced trade facilitations in plant materials and agriculture products.
Importation of plants and plant products into any country poses a huge risk, which, if not properly regulated, could have far-reaching economic and food security implications. And over the years, where import regulatory systems have failed, economies have suffered crop losses, and huge costs have been incurred in attempts to contain pest outbreaks or incursions. In Kenya, examples such as the larger grain borer, famously called Osama, come to mind in relation to maize losses at the storage level.
Kenya and the Netherlands have always had an excellent and long-standing cooperation in the field of agriculture. With the introduction of the ASEP system for import, which is complementary to the electronic system for export certification, which is already in place, we have a result that both our countries can be proud of. Even more so, ladies and gentlemen, as only 1 year ago, the International Plant Protection Convention, IPPC, has updated its international standard on phytosanitary measures, on the phytosanitary certification, which now includes also electronic certification. This is a globally accepted guideline under the WTO, World Trade Organization umbrella. And Kenya, just a year later, already has an operational system in place, and that is very impressive.